So AI is affecting many industries right now, including photography, videography, music. But what does that mean for the 3D industry? Today, we'll cover how AI might affect the 3D industry, the latest tools being developed, and will we all go out of business? Will 3D lose its value? Where is all of this going? With AI going mainstream in 2022 and the ongoing AI revolution in 2023, a lot of people have reached out to me asking me questions, you know, being afraid about their job security. What will that mean for us? Are we all going to completely lose our jobs? Will AI take over? What does that mean for us in the 3D industry? So in this video, I'll be discussing everything from the impacts of AI, the new tools and software currently being developed, and how that might affect 3D artists, which jobs and roles in the industry could be at risk, and which ones could be safe. And of course, I'll also explore the opportunities that this disruption might bring for us. You know, what would this mean for 3D artists? How can we adapt to the changing scenario? Crazy thing about all of this disruption only started 8 months ago. So we'll be going into how this will affect us and the tools being developed. On the 22nd of August last year, UK-based startup Stability AI made waves in the digital art industry by publicly launching its stable diffusion algorithm and a tool allowing anyone to generate stunning images and artwork with just a few keywords and prompts in a fraction of the time it would take traditional artists to create manually. While this took the internet by storm, many of us traditional artists and concept artists were shocked and afraid that it would essentially dilute the industry and take away all of the value and efforts which go behind creating the work that we create. Soon after, it was followed by OpenAI's DALL-E Midjourney and various other powerful tools and software bringing AI into the public eye. Initially, I thought it would only affect digital and traditional art, but now we have tools like Wonder Studio that can automatically take any footage you record and to insert a 3D character and into a live action scene. It can do the lighting, it can animate it, it can compose it, all with a few clicks and a few buttons on a website. It's crazy. And it doesn't stop there. Spline AI allows you to create and customize 3D objects, animations, scenes. It can edit objects and colors, props, generate textures, all in real time through simple text prompts and instructions, you know, describing what you want to create. And if you want to convert a video yourself and load in into an animation, into an existing character, Task AI, another tool which lets you extract motion from videos without the need for expensive motion capture equipment or animators. In fact, you don't even have to move yourself. Crikey AI lets you generate avatar animations using AI. You can just describe the action that you want your avatar to take on the platform. Runaway ML takes it to another level, allowing you to turn any image, video, clip, or text into another video with similar styles, customizations. With 30 other different tools, you can extend it and edit segments, images, replace them with other objects, make images move, reimagine pictures, train your own models, and so much more. If you're looking to create photorealistic 3D models with real-life objects, Luma Labs AI has you covered with a neural rendering technology that captures and converts objects into stunning 3D models that can be exported into different game engines. Meanwhile, down the line, we have Pebbly's product image generator, which transforms boring product photos into beautiful renditions in various settings and sizes for different social media. I know that affects me personally. With the NVIDIA Go Gun and Google's Chimera Painter, you can quickly transform rough sketches into photorealistic landscapes and designs in real time. It's as simple as drawing around with your mouse in like Microsoft Paint. And we have ChatGPT as well, which now integrates with Blender. It allows you to generate plugins and scripts and allowing you to create models and animations inside of Blender with just a few prompts. You know, you don't have to know the technicals of these things anymore. So if you're freaking out, I understand. I was very nervous too. I mean, everywhere you go on the internet every day, like there's a new tool that you hear about, a new program that's supposed to automate someone that you know's job or your own job. And you're probably wondering, like, what's next? Like, am I going to lose my job? Is it even valuable? Is my work even valuable anymore? Unfortunately, there's no simple yes or no answer to any of these kinds of questions. It's more of a double-edged sword. While it offers tremendous opportunity for creativity, brainstorming, designing, and inspiration, and may actually accelerate the growth of the 3D industry, it may also take away options for traditional artists and raises questions about the future of these jobs. With a study by the World Economic Forum predicting that AI could disrupt up to 85 million jobs across 15 industries by 2025, and the creative ones surprisingly being among some of the first, you might be wondering, what does this mean for the 3D industry and 3D artists? So will we go out of business? It's quite ironic, actually. For the longest time, artificial intelligence was seen as something that would replace the menial and repetitive jobs, but never the creative ones. However, after these recent events and advancements, it's definitely proven that prediction could be wrong. For example, AI-powered programs already being developed by companies like Nvidia and Autodesk that can generate highly realistic 3D models just in seconds, potentially decreasing the value of having humans fulfilling that task. I recently came across this mind-blowing app called Poly, which basically lets you create unlimited customizable 4K designs and assets and textures by simply typing in simple text prompts. I mean, you can literally type dry and cracked desert ground and sandy and grainy texture, and it spits out exactly what you want, possibly affecting environmental artists and artists that's like, it's their full-time job and their day job is to create detailed 3D models of real world objects. And these tools only getting more and more accurate and faster as these softwares improve. Every single month, they're having drastic improvements. And you might be thinking like, oh, isn't that good if my workflow is sped up and things are getting done easier and, you know, we could potentially work less? Well, for creative people, a lot of people and their fulfillment is producing and developing the work themselves. And that's where they get fulfillment, not just writing prompts for an AI to produce the results for them. And if it turns everyone into just a prompt writer and removes a lot of the creative work, this could create a ton of job dissatisfaction for people. The other day I found this Reddit post by someone called Stern Safari on the Blender subreddit, where he or she was talking about how they lost all motivation and love for their job when the company started using Midjourney for creating all of the characters and models. And what was once a job focused on sculpting and modeling and creating 3D assets now became a boring, like mindless task of just prompting, photoshopping, and implementing AI-generated images. I get it, to the boss and to the business, it's all about results, saving costs, saving time, rather than the beauty and the craft of the creativity behind it. Might make sense when you're looking at it from a business perspective, but from the view of the artist, there's just simply no meaning in their work anymore. As the user rightly put it, the reason why I wanted to be a 3D artist in the first place is gone. We want to create in 3D space, to play, to sculpt, and feel with our own hands. That's what brings meaning and creativity to people that are creative. And, you know, with my own hands is like the core part of it. But now creativity is being replaced by an algorithm. A lot of people are left feeling angry. Unlike his colleague, whose work, although was a bit low of quality, now gets praise just by typing in prompts. And they happily use these tools and prompts all day to produce these images. And the scariest part is, you know, this is just barely scratching the surface and the tip of the iceberg and the potential disruption. What we've seen in the last few months have absolutely shaken expectations and future is no longer predictable. And it's like all of these stray cases on Reddit just popping up every day, and you can see artists venting out their frustration, strongly protesting and standing against everything. However, there's another way you can also view this, because while AI might automate some aspects of 3D work, it may not completely replicate the creativity part, and that's up to debate. You know, problem solving, artistic judgment, human artists, human interaction, human creativity, and touch actually, you know, might increase in value as people get tired of artificially generated work. You know, that mean that there may always be need for 3D artists in the 3D industry. The industry is only growing and the roles may evolve with the emphasis on less repetitive tasks and more on creative vision and creative work that cannot be automated by algorithms. I mean, all of the tools developed in just the past decade have allowed it to be more accessible for newcomers and 3D artists. As companies switch over to digital advertising as opposed to traditional photography and videography, it might mean that there may be a higher need for professionals to actually manage these applications and create all this work. And that could create a lot of job opportunities and push people out of corporate jobs. But even if all of that's true, I think that small businesses will still opt for using AI creative work, and that makes sense, potentially, you know, lowering the costs and much easier ease of use. Everyone's kind of flooding to it just because it's fast, it's easy, and it saves them a lot of time. They don't have to deal with people, and it's a cheap alternative for people, individuals and small businesses, to kind of create things without having to use artist labor. But the problem is AI often builds off of other people's work, and it's trained off vast data sets of existing art that other people created. So that leads to a lot of copyrights and legal concerns. In some cases, artists have waged legal action and sued companies. that their work has been used and commercialized without their permission, and AI companies just ripping them off, and that could be against copyright laws. Now, it's crazy. It's already become really difficult to tell AI-generated content from actual human work on the internet, causing, you know, artists who are basically just prompt writers to actually get all their attention and praise for automating a lot of the tasks that actual artists are creating and that AI work is generated from. And I believe there's something special about human art and the human touch. It adds a level of humanity and authenticity and uniqueness that I'm not sure if machines will completely remove. Just like how a 100-year-old painting made by hand has increased its value over all of this time, even though all of this digital art has been taking over. And I believe even 3D work created by human can hold the same kind of value, and if you bring that personal and human touch to it. Some roles may disappear in the 3D industry, others will be created, while I believe small businesses will still opt for AI if they're, you know, if the AI gets good enough. I think human interaction and creativity will still hold value. So what can you do as a creative? Well, as with any field, it's crucial to stay up to date with the latest trends and software to stay relevant. Today, it's even more important to have a unique value. The more complex and detailed your work, then the better you have to be, and you can no longer be just average these days. You can't be a generalist that kind of blends in with the rest anymore. Otherwise, AI will take your job. Things are changing fast, and ignoring it, that won't really do you any good. And just like when the internet changed, many traditional businesses operated similarly, and they kind of just did the same thing, and AI will force people to adapt to new ways of working. You need to expand all your skill sets beyond traditional modeling and animation techniques to keep up with the industry. You can't just be like everyone else in creating average work, otherwise I think you're at risk. So by combining artistic skills with artificial intelligence, artists can gain a competitive advantage and make their work stand out and produce better work even faster. Learning how to work with different AI tools is an advantage. AI tools could be a game changer to integrate into your workflow. Previously, you obviously needed a bunch of tutorials to create a lot of things, where these days AI will just solve it with prompts. And you can stay ahead of the curve to continue to create amazing work that brings clients and draws attention to your effort and your 3D business. And your 3D business may actually do better than it ever has because of all these tools that are helping you accelerate your growth. So should you quit 3D and do something else? Well, I think every industry will be disrupted, and jumping to another sinking ship may be even worse. One could actually argue that now might be the best time to get into 3D with the available tools and the disruption that's happening. Back in the day, you know, it was very hard to get into 3D, expensive hardware, very technical knowledge you needed a degree and qualifications and all these things, and it was hard to break into 3D without like going and studying somewhere. But now, with the costs and accessibility and the user-friendliness of everything, it means that anyone can get into 3D and get started, which could be good for the industry. So just like when the internet became popular, many businesses fear that they would lose everything, and it actually only brought prosperity to everyone, and everyone's living better lives than they ever have with the internet. So there's more opportunities that we could ever imagine that could be coming. So a lot of industries will be disrupted over the next few years, but that doesn't mean you shouldn't pursue it. Just like when cameras were introduced, artists were terrified that their work would disappear. You know, a lot of artists and painters' work actually held value, and people that did get into cameras and photography made even more money. And all of the photography stuff only opened a lot more jobs in photography and cinematography. And just because people have the tools to create high-level cinema-level work and have the tools and have the cameras to do all of the stuff doesn't mean that they can. Technically, you can create studio-grade content with just their phone and cameras and laptops, but having access to these tools and this great tech doesn't automatically mean that you'll be successful, nor does it remove the need for experience in 3D or photography or any of these fields. So there's certainly a lot more few lines of text, and luckily the demand of artists and talent is expected to remain strong thanks to the continued growth of the advertising and entertainment industry, the gaming industries, as well as increasing adoption in the fields of architecture, engineering, product design, product advertising. Moreover, the pandemic has also accelerated the shift towards virtual experiences, online content, which has only increased the need for artists and creative people. Big players in the entertainment and media industries, such as Marvel, DC, video game studios like Ubisoft, EA Sports, still heavily rely on artists and creative people to actually develop all of this stuff, and it needs human artists for creating visually stunning, you know, content and visual effects effects and advertising material. Because of this, big companies still recognize and credit the authenticity and originality that human artists and decision makers provide. They are well aware that the value that they bring to the table and continue to depend on them for creating and producing such content. Passionate about 3D and animation and willing to adapt to new tools and tech, pursuing a career in this field can be a great choice. And the future certainly looks promising. And the key is to adapt and to stay on top of all of the changes. Being lazy and falling behind, you know, I don't think will do you any good. So stay up to date with all the tools. Make sure you're always innovating and improving. Make sure you're producing perfect work. You can't just be average. You need to be above the rest. And if you'd like to learn how to take client attraction into your own hands and learn how to go out there and get clients yourself, then watch this video I made on how to go out there and get clients yourself.